was the musical maestro on GMA and mentored some of our finest talents on Australian Idol. He lives and breathes music, so much so that for the 11th year running, he's teaching Aussie kids to sing as one. We love having him on our show. It's the wonderful John Foreman.
Oh, good morning. Good morning. It's lovely to be with you.
Now, we celebrated Good Morning Australia earlier this year.
That's
from
right.
Our Melbourne studios. You weren't there. You were there in spirit.
I was there in spirit, but I'm just thinking, this is sad, isn't it? But it's come to this. I know the network's in receivership. Did you have to sell the whole building?
That's right. There actually used to be a building here, and they've just been dismantled.
Oh, well, you have to do what you have to do. No, that was a beautiful episode, a great tribute to the great man, Bert.
Yeah.
And lovely to see Patty there. It was really great to see, fantastic memories of Good Morning Australia. There's James Morrison and Don Burrows, two of the greats, me with a funny hairstyle there.
How old were you?
Oh, I started when I was 19, and blonde tips were all the rage back then.
Yeah.
Actually, both Bert and I have had some serious hair changes between now and then.
Would you come back to morning TV if we could afford you? Back to Studio 10?
Well, sure. I mean, I love getting up at this time. I could turn up at 10, couldn't I?
Yes.
Something like that.
Those musicians always seem to resist going on morning TV.
Well, no, we were similar to you. We started 8:30 till 10, then I think we were 8:30 till 11, then we were 9 till 11:30, and much like this show, just kept getting longer and longer and longer.
The first time I ever sung was with you on Good Morning Australia, and it was God Bless the Child.
Oh, you were fantastic. I don't know people.
But I said gob.
Oh, well, that's all right.
I know, but my dad was there and everything. Aww. It was beautiful, darling.
We had a lot of great performers came on that show, people who were doing musical theatre and live shows and all that sort of thing. So, yes, I do miss Bert and Patty in the good old days, but it was lovely tribute that you guys did on the show.
Tell us what you've been up to.
Well, at the moment I'm working on Music Count Us In. Now, this has been going for 11 years. It's our 11th year, and basically the idea is to raise awareness of music making in schools and, I guess, to show the importance of music education for young people. So, we concentrate on reading, writing, arithmetic, and that's great, but it's so important that every Australian child has the opportunity to have a really good music education at school. So to celebrate, there's Gordon Rittmeister, Rex Goh, some of the great members of the Idol band there, Greg Royal, who's fantastic as well. So they came along and mentored these fantastic students to record a song that was written by students, recorded by students, and on the 2nd of November at 12:30, kids around the country, something like 500,000 of them, will be performing the same song at the same time in their schools. And it's not too late to register if your school wants to be part of it. It's all free. So you can go to the website musiccountusin.org.au, there it is on screen now, and download. There's materials for teachers. I mean, there are some teachers, especially in primary schools, where the teachers have to know everything. They have to teach all of the subjects. And for some of them, they're not terribly confident with music because they've only done just a little bit of music study, perhaps at university. So this is a great way for them to get more comfortable in front of their class, to say, right, it's actually a good thing for us to sing together. It's good for us to work together. It brings students together in ways that are really unique to music. And we see that with things like School Spectacular, with students coming together.
It is so great what you're doing. And you're absolutely right. A music program is only as good as the teachers, and a great teacher makes it. I've had fantastic ones, and they changed my life. I wasn't cool until I joined the school choir.
but we'll put all the details on our Facebook page, though, because it's so good to get involved in that. Now, we know you've performed with Sally in the past. Have you ever performed without Denise?
I think we did something together on Good Morning Australia, probably, and you had your show on at the same time on Channel 9 back then. And
Mum used to watch Bird, and and Paddy's mum used to watch me. So that the ratings stayed the same.
Oh, that's good.
They'd work out who they were going to watch.
We've done a few things over the years, but nothing quite as exciting as the song that's going to be performed. No, I'm building it up because we've rehearsed it for about 38 seconds, and I don't really know it terribly well.
Sing it in the kitchen, Charlie Poth turned up loud in the kitchen. So
it
I sound good there, but I don't know about it yet.
Any day we see Denise perform on the show is a very good day. Well, so these two really need an introduction. John Foreman and Denise Drysdale are performing for us now. Take it away.
Now, as I said earlier, this is a song that I have the music turned up in the kitchen while I'm cooking. And it sounds fabulous there, but I'm not quite sure here. How do you like your eggs? Okay then.
Okay.
Let's Marvin Gaye and get it on. You got the healing that I want. Just like they say it in the song. Till the dawn, let's Marvin Gaye and get it on.
This is a sexy bit. Wake up, this keeps us to ourselves. Don't have to share with no one else.
Don't keep your secrets to yourself.
It's Karma Sutra show and tell. Please, just like they say it in the song.
Till the dawn,
let's have a game, get it on.
Big finish.
Just like they say it in the song. Till the dawn, let's have a game, get it on. Hooray for John!
Oh, great.
Good to bake it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.